You know, I've been thinking a lot about what happened to Mel Tucker, and I really don't like this shit. How he lost $100 million like that. And I was up doing some research, because you know the aliens never came got me, so I've been trying to find out what happened. And in the course of me trying to figure out why they never came pick me up, I figured out a way of how Mel Tucker could get his $100 million. He could say that girl is an alien. Check it out.
Sydney, Australia, July 1992. Peter Curry awakes to find himself paralyzed and unable to talk, but fully conscious. He feels a weight pressing down on him, and as his eyes adjust to the darkness, he notices a woman with very strange features straddling his body.
This what happened to Mel Tucker. He could have said this.
I got the shock of my life because right on top of me was this female, a blonde female. She was just milky white in color. Her eyes were probably 2-3 times bigger than her human eyes. She had protruding cheekbones and a narrow face that narrowed down to a pointy chin. And on the side of the bed, on the corner of the bed, there was another female, an Asian-looking female. And then the blonde female touches her stomach and points to the sky.
The visitors then disappeared, but not without leaving behind proof that they were there. A single blonde hair.
There you go, Mel. There you go, right there, Mel Tucker.
Curry took this piece of evidence to an independent genealogy lab where biochemist Horace Drew subjected the hair to DNA analysis. The results were not what he expected.
It was very unusual because most people's hair is yellow or brown or black, and this was optically clear like nylon fishing line. There's nobody who has hair on Earth which is optically clear. Normally, a human hair only has one kind of DNA type. In the shaft above the hair, we got a very rare Chinese lineage, about 0.1%, 1% of ethnic Chinese. And then in the other part, we actually got blue-eyed Celtic light-skinned lineage. This shows authentically an unusual DNA, which is fairly rare, which Peter couldn't just have picked up in his bedroom or off the street.
The Peter Curry hair sample yielded very unusual DNA results that just aren't easy to explain in normal, conventional human DNA sequences. You can't really keep dismissing it all as sort of fantasies of the mind or sexual fantasies. And while it didn't absolutely prove that it was alien, because we're only dealing with one hair sample, it did nevertheless prove that we're dealing with something quite unusual.
When we see DNA evidence in the hair of something that doesn't match up with what we would expect to be, old Gaelic DNA mixed with Chinese DNA and blonde hair, the storylines don't add up unless we start to invoke the idea of abduction and genetic interbreeding going back for many thousands of years, all the way to the dawn of history.
There you go, Mel Tucker. There you go, bro. I just got you off that shit. And all you owe me is a hot sausage sandwich. And some Doritos. You should have said her ass was an alien. LSU dad.